Yeah, it's been fun. I still can't believe that we've got the opportunity to play this on multiplayer, you know? Like,
yeah, it was very surprising when we like got to know that, hey, this works online actually.
It's insane.
I'm gonna put it on full screen after this turn.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, the input lag probably is slightly worse than compared to when Revan was hosting. I would assume, at least.
Oh yeah, it's a tiny little bit of input lag.
Oh, that took at the tree's hitbox. This was something useless, I think. Yeah. Okay, that was not the best shot.
Let's try the thing. Oh, it's a bit difficult with the input lag, but might be okay.
By the way, if you are planning to playing some exhibition matches or in the actual league, that move is banned, actually.
Revan told me. I didn't realize it was banned.
Ah, no worries.
But he said it was mean, but he didn't say it was banned, so...
Yeah, no worries. That is, like... I wish it wouldn't be banned, because gunners are not the best class to use anyways. And then wait, they have something good. It's been banned, but it is what it is.
I can tell why it is banned.
It is good damage, but on the other hand, there is only one flamethrower and nobody uses a gunner. So, I don't know. Oh, so close.
Oh, not quite.
Yeah, basically, if I would throw that big on that side, there is chance of instant kill, like in that, like on there somewhere.
Oh, okay. Of course.
But I'm gonna just try. Actually, let's try with this thing.
Yeah, show me how it's done, because I can't figure it out.
Yeah, basically you have to detonate it exactly on top of the pig's head. I'm usually pretty bad with these things, but there is chance for some extra damage. Okay, that was pretty good. I rarely get that much damage with these.
It was like a solid 70, wasn't it? It was not bad.
Yeah, it was. The hosting is actually pretty simple if you wanna host at some point. It's just mostly the controls, like if you do the setup for the controls beforehand, then it's easy to just load those setups and use them. Oh.
Yeah, the input lag is not that bad, but I can see what you mean by by it. Yeah.
It's basically the same lag that I'm having when somebody else hosts, so...
Yeah.
Someone has to suffer from that lag in any case. I did win the last league while playing with that lag, so...
Impressive.
It is definitely playable enough.
Yeah, just something to get used to, I think.
Yeah, yeah. And then there is some things that just can't be done very well, like using the power bar on bazooka on input lag is way more awkward. That's what why I have been accustomed to doing these straight shots.
Mm.
Because if you do it like this, the input lag doesn't affect it at all. Yeah, not bad. Getting rid of the grenadier is always a good idea.
Get him gone. Of course.
Way better shot than what I could have done with that thing.
Not a bad shot. Yeah, I'll pull out some good shots and then just flub. Flub like four or five in a row. Oh, Anti-Pyman's pretty big.
Oh yeah, I wonder if... Oh yeah, I was thinking why those haven't been replaced because all the mines have been anti-P mines have been replaced by normal mines. But yeah, since this map was taken out from the map pool, I guess those grades haven't been changed. Like, there is this glitchy thing where you can just place it directly in the peak and get like 100 and something damage with it, so...
Oh, I was hoping to go straight through all four of those.
Yeah, you always have to aim like a little bit off the peak. If you aim just at the peak, that happens. Okay, where's the... There is the gunner.
Goodbye, gunner.
Should be good water damage.
Yeah,
100 damage total. I would say that was a very good shot with the time you had.
Oh yeah. There was some minor panicking going on there. Do you know, I completely forgot I had a guy.
Yeah, that's the thing with scouts. They get forgotten very easily.
Oh, and I picked up hide for the scout. Very useful.
I mean, at least I cannot use it.
Body blocking a sapper seems a little bit...
That's a kill.
Oof. I had no time to make that shot. I have no idea.
Yeah, usually when there is that little time left, I would just go for a poison. Just because, first of all, poison is very useful, even though it takes time. And secondly, it's easier to throw without actually aiming. And even though the flamethrower trick is banned, you can do extra damage using a water with it. Like, there can be that same basically 100 damage using a water. That was a bit too far from a short, though. Had to try.
Oh, the input lag with the jump is gonna be...
Yeah, I know, that's awful.
Oh, I was hoping. Oh, no. It's very much not dead.
Okay, I'm gonna try something.
I was trying to focus him to get the pea mines.
Mines are now free, but at least the paratrooper is not getting another turn.
I don't see any way you're not getting there.
Yeah, with TNT, it's easy 50.
Not a complete destruction, though.
Yeah, I would say that first paratrooper turn where you hit the tree definitely cost a lot.
Yeah, no, I remember. When that happened, I'm like, this is it. This is the moment.
The hitboxes can be a bit awkward when using jetpacks. They also can be awkward when using bazookas, like shooting on that sort of angle and it just is gonna be, like, the tree is just gonna... act like a magnet.
I didn't think they would be that unforgiving with the hitbox, but lesson learned.
I mean, it was weird. I didn't expect it to hit either, but yeah.
I think I was just freaking out about the input lag a tiny bit. But, you know, it's all good. I'm kind of used to it now.
I'm trying to think which of the maps were good, because some of them are not.
Well. You know. It is what it is.
I don't think...
You pick one. Pick your favorite.
I mean, out of these, my favorites are probably Barnyard and Railroad.
Do Railroad.
Okay. It's not like, it doesn't have a much in it, but it does have the buildings, and I really like the buildings in this game, so.
I'm down for that. That sounds good.
Out of regular maps, I would say Ice Flow is definitely best, but since it's not on this ISO, it would be a bit too much work to play it at the moment.
You have to like drag the map in.
Yeah, basically I would have to just change the ISO. By the way, do you want to go first?
Now you go first. We'll keep doing the same.
Okay. We could have just restarted the game and then like the, it would have randomized it. Again. Okay. I want these crates, but problem is I don't see... Oh no, I forgot that one. Yeah, that minefield always gets everyone. Like, it's so weird because it doesn't look like a minefield.
I wanted to say something, but I thought, you know what, he probably knows what he's doing.
I mean, I don't think I have actually even played this map ever competitively. I have played it for fun many times, but... The time is gonna run out.
And I stood by that barrel. That's a good strat. Yeah, 30 seconds is not a lot of time.
Yeah, it's not. It's usually like maximum of 2 jetpacks. If you spam close enough, there is possibility to use all, but...
Yeah, I think you've got to just know exactly what you're gonna do and just do it straight away. Not a rifle pest.
Hit over the barrel. Did you play this map with Revan as well?
No, this is the first one on this map.
Seems good.
Nah, it's short.
Well, yeah.
Not horrific.
Yeah, if you ask me, everything above 30 is good with mortar.
It's acceptable. Oh, the TNT drops big. In the mines. Oh, that was good.
Yeah, body blocking with a scout is always very easy. Like, especially with sniper rifle or poison, just stand next to someone and hit that guy. And you don't have to do any difficult shots too far away. By the way, that is the worst weapon in the game. One should never use that one.
I was going for the barrel there. I thought the barrel would do a bit more.
Yeah, the barrels are very difficult to use. Oh wait, how much this guy has? I'm gonna try to get instant kill from the minefield. I could try to use the barrel, but yeah, the barrels have never done anything in the league actually, so it's very rare to get any damage with them. He has half the health he had on this turn, so the mine kills him instantly.
On that one. Maybe a bit of a rough one.
Oh, 50.
50s, I'll take 50 to be honest.
Yeah. Same damage than what TNT would have done is never a waste.
There he goes.
Well, you can just do the same thing, basically.
Well, I don't think I'll get it with the input lag that I've got, but I'll try, because I know you've got to do like a rapid.
I mean, if you just double tap it, the input lag usually doesn't matter with that at all.
Oh yeah, that, yeah, I mean, it still kind of did it, didn't it, actually, yeah. I was worried about that.
Yeah, it still picks up the controls, even though you see them a bit later.
Okay, is that, yeah. So you like pre-input things.
Yeah, basically.
Okay.
Okay, I cannot get him close enough to the minefield, probably.
The very aggressive full blast.
Yeah. Some say it's way riskier to do those straight shots, but for me it's just way easier way to use them. It hit the tree leaves again.
Yeah. I think all these little mistakes are costing me a foot. I'm learning lots, and I think that's the main thing.
Yeah. Okay, how much time do I have? Can I do 5 head jumps here? Probably not. Yeah, definitely not.
Yeah, no. Be surprised if you got one in.
Then let's just deal with the Grenadier. I could have done 5 head jumps and later poison him with a scout, but... What is your favorite class to use in campaign?
Oh, that's a good question. I mean, obviously not before Commander and Hero, I suppose. I do enjoy the sappers, they're quite good.
Yeah,
but
for me
you don't get
it's...
a lot of mines in the multiplayer, so they're kind of not my favorite in the multiplayer.
Yeah, for me it's definitely sappers and scouts.
The super shotgun is just too fun to, you know, pass up, to be honest.
Indeed. Also, pickpocketing the enemies and making them useless is very fun just when playing good. Scout.
Yeah, it's brilliant. The religious thing.
Yeah, simple kill.
Harsh.
Okay, I'm gonna try with the barrel again. The distance is pretty good for it. The blast will throw the peak closer to the barrel, if I can aim it in time. He might fly over the barrel. Oh, he's also... Yeah, he flies over the thingy. But yeah, he died anyways.
I shouldn't have wasted so many turns trying to push you towards them.
Yeah. Like, it's fun if you can get the hit, but it's just so... Like, it relies so much on luck, it never happens. By the way, you can collect all of those crates by jumping through the roof.
Oh, can you?
Yeah, if you just jump below it, you can grab it. There is only your guy there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's terrible.
Yeah, the timing and the lag is just like that shot was not gonna happen.
Hey, that's your guy. Don't shoot that guy.
I'm gonna try to use this thing, like, I usually shoot them like from behind the trees, so even if it's too short, I'm not gonna hit myself with them.
That's smart. Yeah, I think if I hadn't wasted that turn trying to shoot my own guy, we might be in a better position.
Yeah, yeah. Or if you would have just grabbed the grate through the floor, so you wouldn't have had to waste time to climbing on the roof.
True, true, true. I might just try and TNT you into the minefield, actually.
It's very close. It might hit. Yeah, I don't know. It's probably gonna take one hit, but if that guy dies, that's a miracle. For instant kill, he would need to hit two mines.
Yeah, you got this.
Let's just take some free damage with the mine. And I definitely wanna poison that guy, because he's on perfect poison health.
He is. I wouldn't have thought you'd be able to pick the crates up on the roof.
Yeah,
from
yeah.
Below. It's kind of crazy.
If you jump below it, like, I did actually do it at one turn, if you missed it. Yeah, like that.
Oh.
Oh.
There's nothing I could do with that.
What is the best way to deal damage here?
We're gonna get a double turn anyway. So it's all good. There he goes.
He should have 40 something if I remember the health correctly, so even though I'm damaging my own guy, you shouldn't be getting any more turns.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. There we go! GG again? We've got to cut these like little mistakes out of it, and I think we'd be good.
Yeah, yeah.
Having an idea of what you've got to do in 30 seconds is... that's the learning curve, isn't it, I think?
Yeah, usually the best idea is just to think ahead what you are planning to do and then do it when the turn starts. There was one snow map I like. I'm trying to think what was the name.
Yeah, pick your favorite.
I think it was Frostbite, but I'm not sure. Like, I have not played... This ISO is fairly new, so I have not played it that much. Mm. I'm definitely letting you go first this time, though.
Okay. It's not gonna make a difference.
Yeah, it's only one turn advantage.
Yeah.
it usually makes a more difference when the medic is on play, so like you can get the tranquilizer, you can disable enemy medic and such, but with these ranks it doesn't matter that much.
Yeah, I did notice that.
Okay, there we go. This map was also in a leak for a short while and then it got taken off.
Is there anything good in the boxes?
I think it might be airburst, but I'm not sure. I'm definitely not good at memorizing crates and stuff. The later crates that are incoming have like flamethrower, either minor and type B mine. One of them had cattle prod, I think. But yeah, there is nothing like OP on this map.
He just kind of runs back up.
Okay, if I take the health, I don't have enough time to use the jetpacks anymore. Do I even have enough time to shoot? I do. There is mines in the middle of the water there, so don't walk forward from that.
Oh yeah, thank you for that. That would have been sad.
Can't take too much advantage from you not knowing the map.
Be an airburst, did it? Just been a normal bazooka.
Yeah, but airburst is still always better, just in case you can get the hit from the extra shrapnels, or if you miss, you can then detonate it and get at least something. Okay, I cannot do the straight shot from here, so definitely not my ideal way to shoot. But it's something.
That's still good.
Oh, slightly too short.
That's awful.
Oh, there is some inputs getting from your controller.
Oh, I can stop pressing, but I was holding a button. My bad.
Yeah.
It wasn't. It wasn't sabotage.
No worries. I was just planning to grab the crate. But now I didn't have time. But yeah, it doesn't matter that much, because most likely poison here is more useful anyways.
I thought it had the controls like separate.
No, it's easier to do like this. That's why both of us can control the menus.
Oh, of course.
In the actual league matches, the controls are not shared, but like for just the fun games and when we play the games nights and such, this is way easier way to do it. This way you can even play a game with like 6 players by making 3 teams of 2 and such. We have also played campaign with 5 players, so basically each player has their own pick.
Oh, that's adorable. I like that.
It is fun until your pick is the first to die immediately when the game starts. Because the AI doesn't incriminate, like they can just destroy you out of the game if they feel like it. Okay, I need to deal with the grenadier before he gets a turn.
Bye, Gerard.
Yeah, next time we are planning to play, we can definitely use the time to set up your hosting system. If you have only 1 hour overall today, then we probably shouldn't do it, like, this time.
Oh, I haven't got enough time to do anything.
Basically, the most important thing to do would be just to do the same control setup thingy we are using now, so otherwise when you play with otherwise when you play with other people, then basically you would have to like reset up the controls every time. Like every time another player joins, the control schemes might be weird and you have to like fix everything. Okay, not ideal, definitely not ideal.
That makes me feel better for flipping the last shot.
It was a bit too high, so I didn't feel like double tapping. I should have done it though. It would have been more damage.
Too short.
Oh, the paratrooper. Okay, not quite. I thought that might be self-damage.
I thought for some reason that that would be far enough, but...
What is the pick up here? A gunner. Let's put both of those guys down. And since Sapper is more valuable pick, if you ask me, I'm gonna hit that guy.
Makes sense.
Oh. Yeah, that's what can happen with the straight shots.
I still kind of worked out.
Yeah, it was some extra water damage, but it might have been instant kill if I would have used, like, if I would have taken, like, done a good hit there.
Best poison I've done so far.
Yeah. I'm gonna grab that one just in case I need it. Yeah, it was anti-beamine.
Oh, that's a good drop.
Most
so
likely.
The drop's always the same and in order, I think.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, that guy has only 50. Well, then I messed up. I was planning to instant kill him, but there is not really point. Kind of want to make use of that poison.
actual.
Oh no, not the. But nah.
Yeah, it's very problematic to do those jumps with the lag, because basically if you jump too late, that happens. If you jump too soon, the jump doesn't do much.
Yeah, it's a rough one.
Oh, the water damage might be just perfect. And it is.
Yeah! Woo!
I do have scout next, but do I have enough time to fix that situation? Most likely not. That's too far away and poison doesn't do much. Yeah, I'm gonna have to try like this. Yeah, no. Not enough. It's some extra damage though. I'm gonna lose my turn. Gonna lose my turn and nothing I can do about that. It is the next turn, so not enough time to do anything.
That took so much of my time, what?
It's not too bad, there should be still enough time for a good shot. Well, that was optimal.
Oh, that's, yeah, that was optimal, you're right. Am I gonna get two in a row, three turns?
No, the gunner is the second pick, so I have a grenadier and paratrooper before that. So at least I don't skip the other turn instantly.
This feels like the correct decision.
This might be huge. If they both land next to the water and the gunner throws the paratrooper in like further away, that might be okay, they are too far away from each other.
It would have been good.
Yeah, that could have been amazing damage.
Yeah, this is much closer than the last two games.
Yeah, indeed.
I think you've still got it in the bag, but
yeah, my scout hasn't taken much hits, and the paratrooper, even though previous hit was good one, he had grabbed 40 health, so paratrooper still has plenty left.
Oh, that wasn't strong enough.
Oh.
I don't know why I didn't hold it for longer. Just gotta let go. I wanted it to go down a nice line over the hill and sort of fix my problem.
Okay, let's put these guys close to each other. Then I just need to not miss this shot.
Oh, nice. Yeah, that's a good shot.
It's something.
Yeah, well, that's a good one.
That guy would have been next, so I had to do it now.
Mm. Oh, pressed it.
No worries, no worries. I have enough time, probably, to craft the crate like I was planning to. that pig is poisoned already, so no reason to use the poison. I'm gonna just try to get as much damage as I can. I wonder how much the scout has left. Oh, not quite in the skip range.
Not quite.
By the way, showing the health like that in competitive settings is usually not a good idea. It is good because now you know that he's not gonna skip next turn, but now since I know the health, I can just knife him and gain the turn anyways.
Choo-choo-choo-choo.
Okay, where is the scout I need to knife? This grenadier has not doing much grenadiering, just using that what was that thing called? Bayonet. No, that's me!
oh. Did I lose a turn then?
Yeah, you did. Because I knifed the pig. Can you press the down once it has gotten stuck?
There you go.
Okay, now it works.
Apologies. I got extremely confused. Obviously. And in my head I was like, oh, I've got 3 pigs left. And I'm really...
No, you had only 2 when the scout was one of them. Oh, I only pressed 1, but something happened.
Oh, it wasn't me. Definitely not this time.
That seems good. Yep, that's a kill.
I'll take it.
I should get closer since there is time, but... If you still have time to play, you can pick the next map.
I've got probably one more in me, before I have to go.
Okay. I'm gonna go fill my glass and I will be right back.
Cool beans! I'm definitely not gonna fuck about in the menu.
Okay, I'm back. Oh, nice. Generated maps.
Yeah, I was gonna have a little look. There we go.
On generated maps, we usually play on a rule that you can only pick one crate per turn, just because otherwise one pick is gonna get everything and nothing for others.
True, true, true.
By the way, do you wanna restrict it one crate or vehicle or just one crate?
What do you mean?
Basically, if I collect the crate now, can I still take the vehicle? That's up to you.
Yeah, go for it. Why not? Is that okay. A rule that you normally don't do it? Or...
The vehicle thing is just like sometimes we decide that we can, sometimes not. But the crate thing is usually just that one crate. Oh no,
it's put all of your pigs on that one spot.
Yeah, that's the probably generated maps. Also, there is no targets for me.
Oh no.
Well, I hope you will not find Super TNT anytime soon.
Well, we'll see.
Super TNT here would be just game over.
I'd find a way to flip it.
Just jetpacks. Still good way to build damage, but at least it's not a Super TNT. A bit too far.
Oh, that was terrible. That was awful.
I mean, I can't say I could have taken that hit either, so I don't know. Oh, nice. Definitely gonna use that right away. And water.
And water. Rest in peace, little boy. Madness gas.
Oh yeah, madness gas is one of my favorite weapons. I would say pickpocket, madness gas, and super shotgun is my three favorites. Not an easy shot to do. Barely soon enough. Oh, is it gonna hit the... Okay, this Rapner is gonna hit the paratrooper. Yeah. Only minor damage. Oh, there is a tank as well. I didn't even notice that. Well, that's mine.
Should have gotten the tank.
The thing is that neither of us saw it before, I think.
I did kind of see it. I just thought they wouldn't be... I don't know why I thought they wouldn't be good.
I mean, at least even if the damage output is not that good, it's good armor.
Just me, or is the sound like cutting in and out a little bit?
It might be parsec issue, it happens at times. Do you hear like double audio or something?
No, the music is just like going.
Yeah, it must be about the connection. Oh, super shotgun.
Oh, well, GG.
How much health? Okay, this guy is the low health guy. I'm don't wanna hit him. Yeah, I don't have enough time to use the super shotgun anymore. At least I got it with the right pick.
True. Bye, Kenton.
Oh yeah, I didn't even notice you picked a different team.
I did.
I have been so accustomed to playing against yellow team because one of my friends always uses that one. No, my super shotguns.
Yeah. Buy super shotgun.
Okay, all the crates are very far away. I don't know if I have enough time to grab any. I might waste my turn with this.
Well, it might be something.
Yeah, exactly. It might be super shotgun or super TNT or something, so... Oh. I mean, if you are confused, the tranquilizers are always banned in fun games because it's just like, they are too OP. Yeah, I forgot to mention that earlier, but yeah, no using tranquilizers in fun custom maps.
Oh, in custom maps, oh.
Especially in the games nights, if there is like four teams playing, everybody gets a tranquilizer. You don't want to be in a team where four pigs get tranquilized.
True, okay, yeah, fair. That's fair.
I don't know if I actually can hit both of them.
I think because you stood so close, you might get it.
Problem is, I might shoot over the first guy and under the second, so I might hit neither. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Shouldn't have risked that. Okay, what's this? Not too bad, but not good either. Yeah, as you can see, I'm not good with mortar at all. There is certain shots I can do, like shooting from behind the tree, very close range, or shooting with the maximum angle from corner to the corner of the map. But other than that, I can't hit much. I mean, tank only has bazooka, so it's not really a threat. You can either destroy it with shrapnel or flamethrower later. Or just take it out last or something, I don't know.
I'm assuming that's what's gonna happen.
I mean, it is good to plan ahead, even though you never know. Yep, that empty crate was not worth it. That guy didn't get single turn. Oh no, that's gonna hit the wall. Yeah. That was awful. Very weird that the peak flew straight up, like, instead of just hitting the wall. That usually does not happen. Not an easy troll. Very good detonation with the lag you have at the moment.
Yeah, I kind of was like pre-pressing it.
Yeah, exactly. That, like... that's what makes it so hard. You just have to guess it.
It wasn't too bad. No, I was expecting that to completely flip that, to be honest.
I'm gonna do something that people cannot do often. Straight shot with a mortar.
Yeah, that was pretty. That was pretty deep to watch.
Oh, straight hit.
Oh, I didn't want him dead, though. I was hoping for a free turn. Cheeky free turn.
Just for fun. You are definitely ahead.
But you've got a lot of armor and stuff going on for you. I don't think that was anything decent.
That was the empty crate.
Oh yeah, just tranquilizers.
At the last moment again.
Should have remembered that there was nothing in that crate.
I mean, I did tell you it was the empty crate.
Yeah, just like, I just like, no, you meant by that. I was like, what do you mean it's empty? I thought you were playing mind games with me.
Just dealing damage and retreating safely. I still have no idea how I'm gonna deal with your scout.
Oh no.
Lightly
shot.
Oh
no. Oh fuck, that could be. That's. I think that was the turning point.
I don't know, you still have way more health overall, I just have the armor. Oh, that might fly over the peak into the water. I just have to try. Okay, not too bad.
Hello, tech.
Yeah, that pillbox is not gonna survive that. Actually, if I have time, I could go grab what's that crate.
Madness gas.
Ah, another empty one.
Very good.
It would have been not fun to swim for that crate and just grab something
you
can
use.
Oh,
so much water damage. Oh yeah. My God.
That was actually very surprising.
No. I'm throwing this now. I think I'm tired, but it is what it is.
Well, at least you are not getting turned with the sapper anymore. How much did he have? 17 here, so good for poison.
Perfect for poison.
This guy's now kind of stuck in this island.
That's where he lives.
Oh!
No, that's a shame.
Yeah, it's not easiest place to hit. Like, that's why I went slightly behind the thingy.
Oh, that was me. Sorry.
Yeah, no worries. Problem is, this shot is near impossible. I don't remember the exact position where the pig is. Yeah, that's way too far. The tanks are so unpredictable.
Well, I've got another chance.
And that was a hit.
Redemption! Rest in peace, little scouty boy.
Yep, no surviving that.
Not bad. Not good, but not bad.
Yeah, not bad.
Here we go. I feel like I'm learning something with every game, though, which is good.
That's how it usually goes.
Man, I'm always astounded by how much time you with the paratroopers, you really utilize every second with them, which is a skill.
Yeah, it's pretty much a must in the like top tier levels on the league.
Well, I knew I wasn't going to win any. That's fine.
I mean, you definitely have a better chance next time we play.
Yeah, I've learned a lot. Like a lot, so it should be good.
Yeah, also
but
if we
weren't as close as mine and Reverend's games, but it's okay.
Also, if we set up the hosting setup for you, then the input lag is my problem and not yours.
Yeah, that was definitely a handicap for sure. But you're used to it as well, so I feel like that might be the way to go.
Yeah,
so,
yeah,
to
definitely.
Be fair, I was kind of handling it not too bad towards the end. I got used to it.
Yeah, we are currently testing the netplay system of the Dark Station. It's still very early stages, so I don't know how it's gonna go overall for the leagues and such. But so far, everybody has to play with a lag on the league, because none of the players is the one who hosts. So you basically have to get used to some input lag in any case, unless the net plating changes it.
So that's hopefully the fix, is it?
Yeah, basically the next net plating works that neither of the players have any input lag, but problem with that is that the game at times goes to desync, and that's pretty much huge problem.
Yeah. Well, it was very fun. I don't know what you were expecting, but there you go.
I mean, I don't usually have any expectations before I see how people play.
Well, I can't wait to, I don't even know what I'm going to say. It's like 12:30 at night. I've got work in 5 hours, so I think I'm going to jump off.
Yeah, no worries, no worries. You can ping me anytime you feel like playing. I have time most of the time.
Awesome. Well, I shall see you around and I very much appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Yep, bye.
Bye.